If for some unknown reason you were not under the impression that there was power creep, the fact that this ability was tied to a 4-4 for 4 in mono red is bonkers. My first cut is Crushing Pain because there are so many ways to prevent damage, or let's say there was just a board wipe and this card could just end up sitting dead in your hand. And I'm going to replace that with Frostbite. I was kind of surprised you didn't already have this in the deck because you're only running Snow Mountains, but this is a pretty good rate. My second cut is Witchstalker Frenzy because this is a cool effect, but you're doing a lot of tapping and untapping shenanigans, so you aren't necessarily always going to be attacking. And while you can trigger it on your opponent's attack phases, just not necessarily what you always want to be doing. And I'm going to replace that with Blading Salvo because this will always be one mana, and this effect in this deck can help you get rid of a pesky arch enemy or something like that by targeting something that will prevent another player from doing something because there's all this choice going on. It's a really good political card. My last cut is Into the Maw of Hell because that first statement, let's say someone has a way to sack a land or something like that, if you get rid of the first part, the second part doesn't happen. So I just don't think it's the best option. I understand why you want to deal 13 damage, though. And the last thing that I really think you were kind of missing in this deck was some additional ramp, and I think that Burgi is a really good budget option.